Welcome back. This time we are painting the metal. So start by grabbing a bright metal color. Base coat all the metal areas with cold steel. We will make this metal painting step very easy for ourselves. Just one base coat, wash it with dark black wash, and then one highlight, and we are done. Paint straight out from the pot. I have diluted it a bit in the pot though. It has a nice way to make it easy for you. Keep the paints nice and thin inside the paint cans, paint pots, whatever. It may seem like I should have painted the hair before the metal, but sometimes you just have to choose what you like. And I think I'm fine with painting the metal first and the hair after. Because it's quite easy to just avoid these two. Base coat every single detail you can find. That needs to be metal color, of course. Easiest way to paint the straps here, or belt buckles, is just to do like this with the side of your brush, one line and another line here, and then just you make four lines with the side of the brush like that. You can paint them with the tip of the brush if you want. It is sometimes hard. I like to do it this way. Start a brush. 1, 2, 3, and 4 times. Like that. Quick and easy. The metal base coat is dry, and now let's wash it with a dark wash, dark black armor wash. Put a few drips on your palette. Check if it is thin enough. It flows nicely into the cracks of the skin. That means, in my opinion, that it's good enough. Start applying it all over the metal parts. Doesn't have to be so precise now. Let's go crazy. Thick wash. Really thick wash. If the wash pools in any weird areas, remove it. Otherwise, it doesn't really matter. We will sort it out in the highlight step. the small detail here on the orange areas and the belt here, the strap, so you can do as you like. I like to wash it just to give it a bit more contrast. Same with the small dots here. If you wash too aggressively here, you can risk painting some wash on the orange areas. You don't want that. And while you're painting with this black wash, you can look on the model, and if you feel like you need to apply some more shadow somewhere, like here, you can just black line it, and here, and under his face here, here I will apply some more, here, just behind the ear. I'm quite happy with how it looks now. While we wait for the wash to dry, we can apply the base color for the purple. This. Murderous Magneta. And again, I have diluted my paint in the cup. So, paint straight from the cup. It's diluted okay. Continue with the final details, because we only have the hair, the hair and the hat left. Of course, the basing too, but the basing we'll do later. And now I see I've also forgot some metal part here. We will fix that later. We will continue with the base coat, so start base coating the hair. I'm not sure exactly what color I want. Some red brownish color. So we will start. Quite bright, light brown. I will try this combination of colors for the hair. Sanguine Highlight, Rucksack Tan. I will mix the colors. I will take a lot of brown. Take 3 brush loads of brown, Rucksack Tan. Take that amount of red and add it to the brown. And you get this color for the base coat of the hair. It looks like skin, some kind of skin tone. We will see how it looks. You can see right now that this looks quite weird, but we will go with it and see where we land. We can just apply some darker washes to it to make it browner. I think we are going to highlight this with some very bright brown, and then we go in and wash it with some brown wash to make it browner, tilt it towards the brown color. That way I think we will probably get an okay hair color. Now is the time to correct the mistake with the metal. This missed part here. Just quickly go in, paint it with the base coat, and then it dry for a few seconds, and then you wash it. A bit more of the base coat on the edge of the hair here to avoid the gray paint to shine through. And now the wash is dry, let's go in with the highlight. Bright metal color, Quicksilver. You can use your fine brush or your all-around brush, or you can take a brush that looks like this. It's up to you what you like the most. I just use my brush, this one, for dry brushing too. I like to have a bit more control of it, where the highlight end up. Start dry brushing it. Forgot to wash this here, I see. So so let's quickly apply some wash to it. Continue with the highlighting. The belt straps here, they don't really need highlighting, but you can just give them a little bit anyway if you like. They're so small, so doesn't matter. And there we go, the highlights part of the metal is done. I think since we did the metal so simple, it needs some more definition or something interesting happening to it. So for this weapon here, that is only metal, we will add some rust effect. And this here will be fine. So let's grab some kind of rust effect. For the rust effect I am using this model wash, Valet model wash, lab rust, it's just rust, dark rust color. Taking this brush for the washing and we just slap it on. Quite a lot. Take a cotton swab and wipe it off. Apply some to the chain, remove it. And apply some to the blade. On his shoulder pad too. Small amount. There we go. While it's still not 100% dry, go back in with the metal color you highlighted with, in this case Quicksilver, and re-establish some of those highlights. I like doing it this way because it blend the highlight with the rust so it doesn't get too harsh. The blade here needs one edge highlight. Re-establish some of these metal areas. The metal is done. And in the next part, we will finish the details. Thanks for watching.